lawns being mowed and pools opening. These are some of the things we expect with summer.
Hey guys, so in today's video what we're going to be doing is diving into a bit of a first impressions on an application called Ellie Calendar. Now this is something that I actually found from the Facebook group. A couple of people were posting the same Medium link and I was like, I've seen this two or three times, what is this? So I actually did some exploring myself, read the full article, and it definitely interested me. Now Ellie Calendar seems like it's being developed by independent developers, which is quite cool. And it's a calendar trying to solve two core things. One is events and obviously managing those, as well as being able to tally up what you need to do in terms of reminders and things to do during your day in an effort to make your calendar look a little bit more attractive once again. So I'm going to brew myself a cup of tea and go and review it. I'm not going to fake make a cup of tea, but I'm actually going to make a cup of tea.
Do not judge me on my cup of tea choice. I mean the actual cup itself. Winnie the Pooh. Whoop. There we go.
Okay, so now that I have Ellie installed, what I want to do today is go over the sort of functions and features. Now this is actually my first impression, so I've literally just installed it. I'll be doing a record on the screen and then it'll be appearing here to give you sort of an overview of what I'm looking at, giving you my first impressions as well. So just to give you a bit of background, you can skip ahead if you do want. This application was developed by a chap called Liam. He is a project manager at Microsoft. He also runs a company called Heart, which I think is where he develops it from. And another chap called Caesar. Basically, this application is trying to solve an issue here. I'll give you a few of my opinions nearer the end after playing around with it. So you can see here, this is my Wednesday view. I have a meeting at 12, it's just been changed to 12. And it's given me my sort of overview of my day, which is quite nice, what I've actually got planned. I quite like the emojis straight away. I really like the design as well. The fact that you can go up to the top and skip ahead if you do want to. And that's quite nice, as well as this sort of like dotting timeline view. I quite like that. So obviously you can end the scroll, so if you sort of scroll down you can actually get that. Just a few things that I've spotted already. When you scroll down you can easily hit the today tab to go back up, which is quite nice. And then in between the calendar events you get this nice giving you how much time block you've got free. And even your night. And there's a little plus button there in case you want to add anything, which is quite nice. So I'm just gonna keep scrolling down because they have mentioned in their sort of experience that their focus was as well as actions, trying to action stuff. So you can see here that it worked out that the length of my haircut, which I definitely need to have, conflicts with my gym. So it's found that there's a conflict with the gym. So if I don't know whether I can click into this. Let me just go back. So obviously it's detected that, which is quite cool, but if I go into the actual event, I can see the event and all the details, but I can actually highlight the places, so I can add a place to it if I wish to, which is quite nice, but I don't actually want to do that. But I can also add a checklist to that specific event too, and the checklist actually look really nice. I really like the way they've placed the icons. It's quite very simplistic but very easy to view, and also the gym as well. I can do the same, so I can do that with any of the items I have. Swiping across, you can basically swipe right, I believe it is, to move out, and move out basically gives you the ability to rearrange it for a separate day. So it says when you're free today, so it'll give you a new time. So actually it will move it to today. Okay, so actually going to move it to today, which is quite cool. So it actually detects the time and brings it up. So I'm actually going to move it out again, and tomorrow at 8 a.m. apparently I'm free. So it's moved to tomorrow at 8 a.m. So it actually auto detects what's wrong with it, and you have, not what's wrong with it, but your free time, and it will give you other items. So it will give you today, tomorrow, and your freedom on the weekend. So it will give you an outline. That's quite cool. I wonder whether it has some sort of detection. It doesn't look like it analyzes your event details because, for example, it might understand whether you go to the gym in the morning that actually appears in the afternoon. So far, if I'm honest, this calendar looks quite nice in terms of the appeal when you're going through it. So quite a nice visual overview of your calendar. I'm not much of a fan of this view, if I'm honest, of the actual sort of agenda view, but to be honest, it's sort of growing on me the way they've structured it, the sort of typeface, the free spots. So you're probably wondering, how do I add an event? So let's say I've got today, I've got 3.5 hours free in terms of meetings wise between there. You can add a new thing. And you can add, it could be a thing related to your to-do, or it could be a thing related to like a meeting, but they give you a few ideas like brush and floss, stretch for 2 minutes, unclutter my life, you know, it's quite specific. And they also have categories too. So if it's a hobby, you can go in there and it will go through. So I really like this actually. This is something that I think I would recommend more for people that are looking for like a more of a sort of like a relaxed calendar and sort of get organized. So let's say I want to add some fitness in there. I want to do some yoga. That's quite cool. So it gives me the day and the time that I want to do it. You can add quick actions to it from here. So if I wanted to add it with a partner application, so for example, maybe I want to take a yoga photo on Instagram, I can add it to the calendar. And once it's added to the calendar, I can click in, I can see all the event information, but I believe at the time that it actually goes off, you can associate it, which is quite nice. Now, each of these calendar events are actually doable, which means that you can click and click them done, which is quite cool. So if there is specific activity inside of there, then it does do that quite nicely. You can add a thing anytime, which is quite nice, and they always refresh the random ideas, which is quite nice, and they have a whole host of different functions as well. They've got everything from productivity to relationships and things like that. And of course, you can add your own at the top, which is quite nice. And that will sync with your calendar and make it quite easy to access there. So I'm sweating a little because it's quite hot, but I'm actually trying to find the settings page. They only have a feedback area at the moment, but I'm just curious about how that actually works. So I'm gonna skip to today. And obviously I've added yoga there as an item. What I'm gonna do is go over to my iCal calendar and actually see whether it's been added as a separate item, because I think that would be quite useful. So I'm gonna go into today view, and there we are. The application has actually created it through a sub calendar, which is quite nice. So it actually has the ability to do that, and that's something that Ellie has not developed, but obviously made a two-way integration. So at the moment, this calendar application looks pretty smart. I wouldn't give it any massive awards yet. I like the design, I like the functionality, I like the concept of adding a thing and adding a to-do, as well as the ability to be able to add a thing and a to-do and be able to do them on the thing, which is created in a separate calendar. I quite like that. It's a dead simple calendar. I'm not gonna say it challenges the likes of Sunrise yet. I'm gonna say it's more of a, I'd recommend this application at the moment more to students, to people that want a light use, and to people that use their to-do list application as a calendar. I'm sure they're gonna be growing it out. The developers are working on it separately. So that's my sort of opinion so far, but I do think this application does have some legs in terms of its visuals and the way it works. I'm sure they'll be adding Google Calendar integration, a settings page, and a host more functions, as well as likes of themes and stuff like that. Maybe I missed them, maybe they were in there, but I couldn't quite find them. But hopefully it gave you a nice overview of this app. Anyway guys, I hoped that you enjoyed today's feature. Let me know in the comments below what you think of Ellie Calendar. These were my first impressions, as you can imagine, so that's the first time I'm using that application. But let me know in the comments below, because I'd really love to hear what you think. Anyway guys, thank you so much for stopping by. Make sure you have a great week. Keep productive, and I'll see you guys very, very soon. Cheers.